half, really, to see if I could do it. And to my amazement, they published things I'd written, the standard being so low. Then I thought, well, if it's that easy, I'm going to switch to writing, because it's obviously miles quicker than illustrating, much better paid. You get paid royalties instead of a lump sum. So I'm going to switch over to writing. But then I found that because it's that much easier to do, many more people are doing it. And it's much more difficult to make a name as a writer than it is as an illustrator, because for every person who can draw and paint well enough to get into print, there's 20 who can write well enough to get into print. So it slowly dawned on me over the years that the best thing to do is your own picture books. It took me about 10 years for me to realise this. And so ever since then I've been concentrating on doing picture books. And then slid into kind of strip cartoon books later on, through pressure of space. Was a painter and tried cartooning and tried writing plays and tried doing radio play, and I've still come back to the illustrated book as the best possible thing for myself. Anyway, I feel if you have a fine art painting exhibition, not that I could, but you get through to about a couple hundred people go to it. If you write a radio play, it vanishes amongst thousands of others and it's gone in half an hour, whereas the illustrated book is around for a long time and has a much more sort of permanence, really. But I don't see why a book done in pictures is necessarily inferior to one done in text. But it's absolute gutter medium in England, because we're such a literary based country, I suppose. And then having got the character coming into the thing, I worked with the dictionary a lot, because I always work from the words and from the literary side of things. And I spent a long time going through the dictionary and making lists of words which either sounded bogeyish or could be turned into bogeyish stuff. And started a whole filing cabinet drawer of stuff, because most of the things, when you publish something, only a fraction of what you actually do gets into the book. Appearance and anatomy, what they look like, flora and fauna and big section on slime, bogey buildings, shops, clothes and equipment, literature, all this stuff. And the bogey glossary was the main thing. List of words which were used, list of which didn't get in the end. Cupid and blanket and boglet. And muckender was quite an interesting one. That's an 18th century word for handkerchief, which is quite a good word for it, because it's where all the muck ends up. So muckender is a good word for that. And huge amount of stuff which doesn't actually get into the book at all, but helps you to build up the thing in your mind so you can make it a bit more convincing.